What's going on, guys? Dr. Brute7 signing in back with another tutorial video. So this video is about the all-in-one switch updater, which is going to allow you to update the Atmosphere custom firmware along with Hecate SIG patches and the official firmware without having to use a PC. You would be able to perform all these updates through your jailbroken switch. Before moving on with the tutorial, the first thing is that I'm using a fresh SD card where I have the bare minimum. I only have the updated Atmosphere files, not the SIG patches. I had to use the most updated files because I am on the latest firmware version. If I use any previous custom firmware files, it's going to break the jailbreak. Apart from that, this app highly recommends you to be on the FAT32 format. So XFAT users highly recommend that you don't use this app or use this method because it might result in data loss or data corruption. I won't be able to use this app because my primary SD card is on XFAT format. One last thing is, if you go to the tools menu, whenever a new update, a software update for the updater becomes available, it's going to show up here at the very top. So go ahead and perform the update before moving on with the update process. I am on the latest update. I'm going to link you guys to the GitHub page where you'll be able to download the RAR file, extract the contents, and plug in your SD card, copy all the contents and paste them to the root of your SD card. If it prompts you to replace any files, go ahead and do so. Okay, let's move on with the update process. So first thing, you're going to update the Atmosphere custom firmware. Never update the official firmware. Whenever Nintendo drops in a new update, just hold on until a new update for the Atmosphere custom firmware drops. Nintendo doesn't want, or no company wants us to jailbreak their system. So obviously, whenever a new official update drops, it's going to mess up the custom firmware. Always perform the custom firmware update before moving on with the official firmware update. Okay, so under the Atmosphere tab, go ahead and download the latest version, which in this case is 1.3.0. It's going to go ahead and click on continue, and it's going to download the update, and it says to overwrite the existing INI config files. I'm just going to go ahead and say yes, and there you go. It says, would you like to delete all the custom sysmodule startup flags? Now, those who are using sysmodules, please go ahead and select yes. Since I don't have any sysmodules running, if I go ahead and select yes, I'm going to get an error message. If by any chance you get an error message, just don't panic, restart the whole process and select no. And yeah, there you go. Okay, now it's prompting me if I want to download Hecate, the bootloader. So I'm just going to go ahead and select yes, and I'll overwrite the existing INI config file. It's asking me if I want to copy the Hecate payload to Atmosphere reboot payload.bin. Just go ahead and select yes. Now it's going to perform a special soft reboot. Just hit continue and we'll be taken to the Hecate screen. There you go, the latest version of Hecate, which is 5.7.2, has been downloaded. Now go to payloads. You won't get all these options because I already had a couple of these bean files pasted. So yeah, you might only get one option. Just go ahead and select that. I'm just gonna select fuse.bin. There we go. Okay, so now let's go ahead and update the SIG patches. If for any chance you get any kind of error messages or run into any kind of issues while trying to run certain softwares, just go ahead and download the Hecate IPL.ini file. I am not going to do that. I'll just download the SIG patches. There we go. The changes will take effect on the next boot. I'm just gonna go back. Let's just go ahead and download the latest version of the firmware. So the latest version of the firmware, which is 14.0, available for download, and it says where it's going to download the firmware from, and I'm just gonna go ahead and hit continue, and this is gonna take enormous amount of time. All right, guys, so here I am back. The firmware version has been downloaded, and it's giving me a prompt that if I want to launch Daybreak to install the downloaded sys update. So I'm just gonna go ahead and press yes. Directly takes me to Daybreak. So far, I'm having a very smooth experience. Hopefully it stays till the end of the video like that. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and continue and preserve settings, install FAT32 plus XFAT. This I personally recommend because it's going to select the designated file format and just install it accordingly. So I'm just gonna go ahead and install FAT32 plus XFAT and continue. There you go. It depends. It actually depends. It might not be as fast as how you just saw here. In my case, it might take for you a minute or two. So I'm just gonna go ahead and reboot. And okay, let's try to run this game now and hope for the best. This is a smooth as homebrew app. On my first impression, it gave me a really hard time when I was trying to run the apps or like tinfoil. It was giving me a really blasted shitty time, but this here is not the case. I am very much surprised and happy with the experience. Let's just try to run tinfoil and see how it runs. Amazing. Alright guys, so that is it with this tutorial video. So that was the all-in-one Switch updater for the jailbroken Nintendo Switch that is going to help you to update the custom firmware files, the SIG patches, along with the official firmware files with the press of a couple of buttons. You don't even have to touch your PC. Hope this tutorial video was helpful and informative, and if you did find it useful, don't forget to like the video and comment. That is going to greatly help my channel by boosting it up. New viewers, please don't forget to subscribe if you do find my contents useful. I am very much active on my channel as well. I try to answer all your questions in the best possible way. So I guess this is it for this one. Until next time, Dr. Brute 7 signing off. Peace.